many.
Olauda Equiano, whose first slave name was Gustava Vassa, obtains his freedom in London and becomes a key figure in the abolitionist movement. His autobiography really becomes the transforming political document to the abolitionist movement.
Olauda Equiano is just one of the great campaigners consigned to the margins of history, while William Wilberforce is represented as the all-conquering hero who abolished slavery. However, no matter which great abolitionist you choose, you will find even greater forces behind them, from the radical Christianity of the Quakers to the workers forming what would become the trades union movement.
The other thing about Equiano was he's the one who connected the artisans of the London Corresponding Society in 1792. He connected them with the steel workers, the coal miners, and the factory workers of Sheffield. And it was this conjunction of the industrial proletariat and the artisans of London, which historians have often seen as the beginning of the English working class as a whole. But it was Olauda Equiano who had brought them together.
The period where you see the most solidarity between enslaved Africans and the white working class, in Britain anyway, I think were the early years of the abolition movement. Starting in the late 1780s, hundreds of thousands of Britons signed petitions to Parliament against the slave trade. And amazingly, a lot of these petitions came from workers. There were 769 metal workers in Sheffield who signed a remarkable petition to Parliament that said, in effect, you might expect us to be in favor of the slave trade because we sell a lot of the wares we make to the captains of slave ships who use them as trading goods to buy slaves in Africa, but we want to express our solidarity with our African brethren, and we are told that they do not wish to be slaves.
It's a very slow movement, a kind of shifting of the kind of tectonic plates underneath Western life, late 18th century. And the shift is, you know, Enlightenment writing and kind of changes in theological views. But those small tectonic changes produce tremendous changes above. And one of the things that they do is to open to question the very existence of the slave trade and slavery.
The decisive event that affected all of culture at the time, it has to be the first successful slave revolution in human history, and the successful break from European imperial powers. And that's the Haitian War of Independence that breaks out in August 1791.
It's one island, originally colonized by the Spanish, who effectively abandon the western portion of the island, which the French squat on.